Hello, welcome to FX Bootcamp. Today is Friday, July 20th, 2007. My name is Kurt Worley, and this is your New York session video briefing. It's a video review of what we did in the live classes today at fxbootcamp.com. Here is the USD Swiss franc, otherwise known as the swissy, as it looked about 90 minutes after the open of the New York session today. Now, it looks like today's high, which was reached during the London session, was at 2065 right there. That is very close to today's R1 pivot point over here on the pivot point plotter at 2064. So that's looking like a rejection of R1. Now, some of the early New York traders saw that and entered short trades around this area here, which so far have taken this pair down to the 2032 level. Now, notice how 2032 right in here is also visual support going back earlier today and into yesterday's trading as well, latter part of yesterday's trading. We've also got today's central pivot point at 2026 right there, which happens to overlap nicely with the 200 EMA on this 15-minute chart. Now, both those levels represent potential support. So if you're seeing this chart for the first time, you really don't have permission to go short right now because stochastics is crossed against you down here. Stochastics crossed pointed up. And we're fairly close to these support levels. So at this point, going long actually isn't in the cards either, because the 5 and the 8, the 5 EMA right there, the 8 SMA right there, are pointing down against you. You want to see a 5-8 cross before you consider a long trade. So right now, we're waiting for something to happen here, waiting for something to develop. So let's zoom in a bit here and just wait for something to develop. A couple more candles. Whoa, look at that. There's nothing on the news counter, so what the heck's going on here, right? Well, the U.S. stock market just opened 30 minutes ago, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average has been dropping like a rock. Some bad news this week about the subprime mortgage lending sector has spooked the markets, and investors are pursuing what many analysts describe as a so-called flight to safety. These safe haven flows usually mean buying of government bonds, which lowers treasury yields. And when treasury yields go down, U.S. dollar weakness often follows, and a weaker dollar pushes the swissy downward. Okay, so we've broken visual support. This was based on the 200 EMA and the central pivot point at 2026. And all in one candle. Did it all in one candle. We've also got a stochastics cross. Look down here at stochastics. Crossed on the downside. Favoring a downside move. So, and we've got some currency correlation, by the way, as well. Let me look at that real quick. Notice the these are the so-called pivot points. Four major currency pairs. Got the pound on the left. Got the euro right here. Swissy here. Yen there. Notice how the Swissy and the yen are now both below the central pivot points and showing red, while the euro and pound are both above their central pivot points. Now, unfortunately, the pound isn't doing much yet, but it already got a boost earlier from GDP news during the London session, so I'm not too terribly surprised it isn't doing a whole lot just yet. So the euro is showing some green, so that's all good. And again, it's above the central pivot point. So let's go back to the Swissy chart now and see again what happens. Okay, here's the 15-minute chart. So I'm definitely thinking down now. I'm thinking down. Time to look for a short trade entry. Now, a retest of the central pivot point or a retracement to the 5 EMA would make for some good entry points. Let's see what time brings us here. Aha, excellent. There we go. There's a retest of the 200 EMA right there and the central pivot point. Let me isolate that. See what the marker right there? Got the retest of the 200. In fact, it went all the way up to the 5 EMA right there near 2029, I believe it was. So you're in at 2026, let's say, in at 2026. And now what about profit target? Where might this go? Well, I mentioned earlier the bounce at R1. Again, a bounce at R1 earlier today during the London session. Now, a bounce at R1, based on pivot point theory, suggests a move to S1. Again, basic pivot point theory, R1 to S1. Now look at today's S1 at 1.2000 exactly, a major, major psychological level. In fact, that number has been a very tough nut to crack over the past couple weeks. Let's take a look here at the Swissy's daily chart to give you a closer look at that. Here's the daily chart. Now 1.2 held as support in April, late April back here, 1.2 is holding as support. And over the previous seven trading days, you see right in here, We've had several pierces of 1.2, but not a single candle close below that level. So I'm expecting the 1.2 to hold as support. Now, you know, could price break S1 and 1.2? Yeah, sure it could. But look, you've got an overlap of a major psychological level with an S1 pivot point, which is a logical target after a bounce at R1, and it would give us a net of about 22 pips based on our entry. Also, based on price action in recent days, buyers usually show up very quickly after price pierces of 1.2 level. So I'm out of this if it reaches 1.2. Let's go back to the 15-minute chart and take a look at what happens here. Here's the 15-minute chart again. Former candle. Boom! Just like that. 22 pips in less than 15 minutes. That was easy, right? Okay, did I leave some pips on the table? Let's find out. I sure did. Look at that. Price did go farther than we expected. Today's M1 pivot point, show you here on the right on the pivots chart. Today's M1 pivot point was at 1981, and the low of this candle right there is 1980. So the break of S1 did produce a very predictable bounce at M1. And moving forward here, that vertical line coming up as London close and price finishes the day above 1.2. I'm still a happy camper though, don't get me wrong. 22 pips in hand, a conservative repeatable entry, took profit at a logical target, a stress-free trade. Today is Friday, July 20th, 2007, and this has been your New York Session video briefing by FX Bootcamp.